Hello everyone! In this video, we will continue our mathematical optimization series with mixed integer linear programming in CPLEX. In the last video, we have gone through the basics of CPLEX and docplex package in Python. We learned how to solve a mathematical problem using CPLEX solver. You can watch this video with the link above. Let us start with our topic today. I will briefly remind you what the integer programming is. An integer programming problem is a mathematical optimization program where some or all of the variables are restricted to be integers. If all variables are restricted to be integers, then that model is called integer programming. If some decision variables are not discrete, the problem is known as a mixed integer programming problem. In many settings, the term refers to mixed integer linear programming, where the objective function and constraints are linear. Note that integer programming is NP-complete. There are two main reasons for using integer variables when modeling problems as a linear program. First is that the integer variables represent quantities that can only be integer. For example, it is not possible to manufacture 4.7 iPads or 6.2 microphones. And the second, the integer variables represent decisions, and so they can only take binary values, which are 0 or 1. These considerations occur frequently in practice, and integer linear programming can be used in many application areas, like production planning, scheduling, and many more. The standard or the canonical form of the MILPs are the following: maximize or minimize C transpose X plus K transpose Y, subject to constraints AX less than or equal to B, DY less than or equal to E, and we have boundary constraints X and Y greater than or equal to 0. Lastly, we have the integrality constraint on X. So X needs to be an integer. In this problem, A and D are the matrices, B and E are the constraint constants. C and K are the objective function coefficients. We are trying to determine the best decision variables, which are X and Y. Let us move on coding an instance of an MILP on Python. Consider the following maximization problem. We are trying to maximize 2X plus Y plus 3Z subject to the constraints. First constraint is X plus 2Y plus Z less than or equal to 4. The second one is 2z plus y less than or equal to 5. And the last one is x plus y greater than or equal to 1. Suppose that the decision variable x is a binary, z is an integer, and y is a continuous variable. For coding part, as you remember from our previous video, we first need to import model function from docplex.mp.model. Let me first run this line. We imported our function. In the next step, we create our model instance and name it MILP. In step 3, we are going to add decision variables. Again, X is a binary, Y is a continuous, and Z is an integer decision variables. We should not forget to add the lower bounds for Y and Z. We add decision variables by using binary var, continuous var, and integer var functions, which corresponds to binary variables, continuous variables, and integer variables, respectively. We also give a name to our decision variables. We can move to the adding constraints. We already add the boundary and integrality constraints when we define the decision variables in step 3. Now, we have three more constraints. First, x plus 2y plus z less than or equal to 4. Second, 2z plus y less than or equal to 5. And last, x plus y greater than or equal to 1. We completely added the constraints. Then, we can define our objective function, which is 2x plus y plus 3z. Remember that we want to maximize the objective function. We set the objective function and the aim as maximization by writing max in a string format. We also use model .print information as we used in the previous video. It gives us a nice summary of the model. It says that our model named MILP has three variables, which are one binary, one integer, and one continuous. We have three constraints. Our objective is a maximization, and our problem type is an MILP. So our model is ready to be solved. As you remember from our previous video, we will use function solve. When we call this function, it evaluates the model. It shows the solution of the model, which is objective function is 8.5, where the values are 1.5 and 2 respectively. Let us have a look at the result and the values of the decision variables. We again use print solution function to see the optimal values. We see the optimal objective function value, which is 8.5, and the optimal decision variable values, which are x equal to 1, y equal to 0.5, and z equal to 2. We have briefly discussed mixed integer linear programs. Thank you for watching. Let us know if you have questions by writing a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and like our videos. See you in the next videos. Bye.